Kill the Pharaoh. A thriller serial in 8 episodes by Victor Pemberton. Kill the Pharaoh. Episode 1. Village of the White Scorpion.
I'm sorry, I don't speak Arabic.
Then I will speak English. Is the seat taken, please?
Oh, I do beg your pardon. No, no, of course not.
Thank you, dear lady, thank you. The air condition. I always say if one has to travel on a train in Egypt, one must always pay the extra for the air condition.
Will it get much hotter, do you think?
Oh, dear lady, we have only just left Cairo. By the time we reach the south, those poor devils in the second class will not be able to breathe.
Oh, so much for my travel agent. He assured me I'd find Egypt much cooler in October.
Then it is your first time down to Luxor?
Yes.
Oh, you will have much to see.
Oh, I feel as though I already know the place. My father used to tell me so much. You see, he was an Egyptologist. Sir Richard Warwick.
Sir Richard Warwick? Excavator of great tomb at Harshak in the Valley of the King?
Yes, that's right.
Dear lady, this is fantastic coincidence. I knew him. I knew him well.
Really?
Of course. All Egypt remembers this man. But for him, the great tomb would still be covered beneath the sand.
Do people still go there to see the tomb?
There is nothing to see, dear lady. It is a great sadness to me that since departure of your father, the tomb has remained exactly as he found it, lonely in the sand and dust, high up in the hills above the Valley of the Kings. And still, we have no hope to find name of Pharaoh who may once have rest there.
With all due respect,
a shoeful passport, Mithvala.
What does he want?
He is policeman. He asked to see your passport.
It's a normal procedure on your train.
Not at all. I think maybe they look for someone.
There you are.
Shukran.
Thank you.
Ragil Dara Kabaratra Minwain.
The policeman asked how long the man in corner has been on train. Do you know?
Most of the time, I think. Oh, since Cairo.
Min Masa.
What's happening? What are they doing?
They are going to take him off the train.
What's wrong with him? Why is he staring at me like that?
Don't be frightened, dear lady. He is drunk. He will be taken off the train at the next station until he has time to recover.
That man was not drunk.
No?
I happen to be a doctor. He looks a very sick man, but whatever it is, I can assure you he is not drunk.
Excuse my ask, dear lady. Why do you wait here on platform?
A friend of my father is supposed to be meeting me. I don't know what's happened to him.
If I may suggest, railway station is not a good place for unaccompanied lady to wait. The sun takes only a few moments to set. Soon it will be dark. To which hotel do you go?
Oh, the Winter Palace.
I tell you, we shall take an arabana,
a
horse carriage.
Oh.
If we hurry, we shall still see the sun disappear behind Temple of Luxor. Now, dear lady, you are really in land of the pharaohs.
Oh, dear.
I hope it's not bad news.
It's a letter from my friend, the one who was supposed to meet me. He says his father's been taken ill. He can't leave the village.
Ah, a disappointment.
Mm. He wants me to take a boat and go out there first thing in the morning. It must be pretty serious. He'd never have done this.
What village is this?
Oh, a place called Hazia. Do you know it?
Hazia?
Oh, is it that bad?
Oh, no. Just that it is a small village, 5, maybe 6 miles from Luxor, on the banks of the Nile.
Oh, sounds fun.
I hope you will think so, dear lady. The Nile is in bad flood. For many years, we have not such disaster. However, if you need help to get boat, I am entirely at your disposal. My shop is very close to Quayside.
You have a shop?
I am dealer in rare antiquities. None better in whole Upper Egypt. And, of course, for the daughter of Sir Richard Warwick, I give very special prize. Here, I am going to give you my card. There, do you see? Mahmood. That's me.
Oh, yes. Well, I'm Elizabeth Warwick, and I'm very pleased to know you, Mr. Mahmood. And I shall most certainly visit your shop.
Splendid, splendid. We shall talk, drink mint tea, and talk some more. But if I may warn you, dear lady, when you go to village of Hasia, please do be careful.
Careful? Why?
You may find it a little, shall we say, primitive.
Oh, it's quite all right, Mr. Mahmood. I don't think you need worry about that. I am not used to afternoon tea and cakes, even in England.
Do sit down, Miss Warwick.
Well, thank you.
The waiter told us you were joining our table tonight. It's an honor for us. Oh, quite a celebrity around here. We saw your picture on the local newspapers.
Oh, really?
I'm Charles Villiers. This is my wife, Margaret.
How do you do?
Hello. Welcome to the land of the pharaohs. I hope you brought your mosquito spray. You'll certainly need it.
Are you on holiday, Mr. Villiers?
More or less. Maggie and I have been saving up for this for 10 years. It's been a bit of a struggle. We've finally made it.
Are you interested in Egyptology?
Only what I've read. My unit was out here for a time in the good old days, you know.
It's a beautiful country, isn't it?
Well, I don't know about beautiful, but it's certainly not without interest.
Palm trees, desert, and mosquitoes.
I was very sorry to hear about your father. It must have been a big shock for you.
Yes.
Terribly sad to think he never had the chance to finish off his work up at that tomb. Tell me something, Miss Warwick. Is it true that when your father dug up that place, he found it absolutely empty?
Yes, it's true.
But surely, in most of the tombs they found, not only the remains of the king, but most of his treasures.
In this case, nobody knows if this was the tomb of the king. It wasn't in the valley itself, but in the hills above.
And the treasures?
Well, if there were any, they could have been taken by robbers at any time. Right back through the centuries.
Fascinating.
When I'm dead and buried, I don't want anyone to dig me up again.
Maggie, that's enough wine.
Oh, Charlie, don't be such a...
Did you hear what I said? No more wine.
Now look what you've done. You've spilled it all over my dress.
Sorry about this, Miss Warwick. Too many cocktails before dinner, I'm afraid.
Oh, that's quite all right. Dash the mosquitoes. I do see what you mean. They've got a nip like a pin.
Yes, I'm afraid you've come at rather a bad time for the mozzies. They're all over the place. What a menace.
That's nothing. You wait till you get to that village downstream.
I beg your pardon? What village?
We mean you're bound to be having a look at some of the villages along the Nile. Most people do. Some lovely little places.
Really? I thought the Nile was in flood.
Yes,
they'll bite you. Yes, they'll bite you, all right.
Maggie. I'm sorry, Miss Warwick. I think I'd better take my wife upstairs. She's not feeling very well. If you'll excuse us.
Well, of course. I'm all right. I can manage. Thank you.
Oh, by the way, if you do happen to need a boat at all, we can put you on to a good boatman.
Thank you.
A nice little chap took us on our trip to Aswan and back. Just mention our name, Villiers, he'll know.
Oh, good, I'll do that. Oh, how do I find him?
Oh, you'll find him down on the quayside near the hotel. Ask for Araby. Ahmed Araby.
Lady, lady, you want a boat? I have best boat in whole Upper Egypt.
Lady, this man lies. His boat will sink after 2 minutes. 2 minutes, lady.
Look, lady, do not listen to these men. They are peasants. My boat is best for you.
But for you, lady, I give special price. 10 piastres to go to Banana Island.
7 piastres.
6 piastres.
5 piastres, lady. Where in whole Luxor you find such a bargain?
Look,
how many more times do I have to tell you I do not want to go to Banana Island?
Oh, you'll not go to Banana Island?
No, 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 Crocodile Island, oh, or anywhere else. Oh. Now then, which of you is Ahmed Araby? Well?
Here is Ahmed.
Are you sure?
Sure. I am Ahmed, son of Nile. My boat is best of all. You have made wise choice, lady. You will see.
Which is your boat, Ahmed?
There. The one with white sail, blue wood. Horus, god of the sun.
I want to go to the village of Hazia. Oh, what's wrong? Where are they all going?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.